Hi students, I am Deepak Bhabur from New Catholic Mission School, Jhabwa. Dear students, I welcome you all to this English class. We are going to study today the chapter, second chapter. It is from Moment and for class 9th students. The name of the chapter is Adventures of Toto. Dear students, it is written by Ruskin Bond. Before going to the chapter, I would like to ask you few questions I have set for you. Why do we keep pet animals or birds? This is a big question. Sometimes we feel alone, aloof, and we want somebody's company. So there are people, they have that concept that animals or birds can become their friends, and they can enable them to spend time, the time which is critical and difficult. But these animals and birds, they become good friends to them. Therefore, they keep animals. Second question, do any one of you have pet animals at home? Yes, I'm sure you may be having pet animals or birds. You play with them, you entertain them. In fact, they also entertain you. So, from both the sides, animals as well as human being, they are required friendship, they are required somebody's company so that they can create the atmosphere which happens to be pleased them. What are the challenges we face while nurturing them? Of course, nurturing, we give them bath, we provide food, we provide shelter. We also look after them whenever they are in difficulty, whenever they are sick, whenever they don't feel good. So they need our help. So how do we nurture them? At the same time, do we face difficulties? Of course, if birds and animals, they cannot speak, they can listen, they have sense to understand, but not as human being can understand. So here, very difficult to make them understand, but if we give them regularly training, I'm sure they will understand and they will try to adjust with you. The thing now, let us get into the chapter. This is a humorous and adventurous story of a naughty monkey. We are going to study about a monkey, and it is a very naughty. Its name is Toto. The writer's grandfather bought the monkey from a Tonga driver. The pranks played by Toto have been narrated in an interesting way. A very good story we are going to study today. Toto is a monkey, and that monkey is very mischievous, very mischief. At the same time, a grandfather, he is fond of animals. He also arranged a very good zoo, and he collected many kinds of animals, and he kept over there all types of animals. So we can understand that he was very fond of animals. Here explanation of the chapter, dear students, you can see Tonga driver is here and this little red color monkey, it is tied to a feeding trough. That means this container is known as trough. So it is said the writer's grandfather purchased a monkey named Toto from a Tonga driver by paying 5 rupees, because grandfather, he does not like animals to be tied. He thinks that animals should be freed, and therefore he wanted to make free. He wanted monkey to be freed from Tonga driver, and he bought it for 5 rupees. The Tonga driver had tied a little red colored monkey to a feeding trough so that he could not run, and there was also a purpose of tying, because monkeys are very mischief animals, so they can run away. Thinking that this Tonga driver, he tied it. When the writer's grandfather saw the monkey, he had a desire to aid him to a collection of animals. Yes, I told you, he arranged or he invented his own zoo, and he collected various kinds of animals and kept them all in the zoo. So grandfather, he thought to aid one more animal so that the place will become so interesting and so beautiful, because if you are having many kinds of animals, they will become more funny. They will become the source of enjoyment. So that is what he thought, and he bought the monkey. Toto was a pretty monkey. No doubt it was a pretty monkey. His bright eyes, see, it is the explanation of, or the figures of a monkey completely explained here. Eyes sparkled with mischief beneath deep set eyebrows. The structure or the beauty of eyes is elaborated here. And his teeth also, which were purely white. Purely means it's like a pure. It's like a purely white, were very often displayed in a smile that frightened the life out of elderly Anglo-Indian ladies. Anglo-Indian ladies also mentioned here. We know South African. Because of the too much heat, their skin is almost black. So they are known as Anglo-Indian ladies, means the teeth displayed or the teeth shown by a monkey, it seems like this lady, Anglo-Indian ladies, and frightening also. The word is used here, frightening. But these hands looked dried up. His hands looked dried up, as though they had been pickled in the sun. Okay, hands were dried for many years. We know monkey has also the third hands, that is its tail. We will understand it. Yet his fingers were quick and wicked. Fingers were very expert, means to hold or to catch anything, it responds quickly, and it helps monkey to jump from one branch to another. And his tail, you know, as I was explaining you, while aiding to his good looks, grandfather believed a tail would aid to anyone's good looks. If you have tail, means monkeys or animals, they are without tail, it means they are incomplete. something or some part of the body is missing. So we would consider them, it is not complete animal. Grandfather has different thinking. Grandfather very nicely narrated and emphasized that if animals, tail animals are there in the zoo, it would add some more beauty. So he thought it is good for his zoo. Also served as a third hand. Yes, I told you this is a third hand of monkey because the tail supports monkey a lot in whatever time. He could use it to hang from a branch and it was capable of scooping. Scooping means scooping up any delicacy that might out of, that might be out of reach of his hands. There are some places which are not approachable. So monkey uses its tail and easily can approach the place it wants. Dear Anglo-Indian, a person relating to both Britain and India, of course Britain and India, the people belongs to Britain and India. Pickle means food that is preserved in vinegar, and the scooping up, that is lifting, I explain you. Let's go to the next slide. It says grandfather always fused when grandmother, sorry, grandmother always fused when grandfather brought home some new bird or animal. Fused, it is said, grandmother always annoyed or irritated, but poor lady could not do anything because husband or grandfather, he wanted to fulfill his desire and he was fond of animal. So she used to tolerate, she used to bear this type of attitude. But it is said fused means she was always irritated with the attitude or behavior of grandfather. So it was decided that Toto's presence should be kept a secret from her until she was in a particular good mood. If she is good or she is in a particular mood, good mood, at that time they are going to reveal the secret. The secret was that monkey will be kept in a place where grandfather, grandmother is not aware. So all this story was created by grandfather and the writer. Writer himself is speaking all these things. Ruskin Bond. Grandfather and I put him away in a little closest opening into my bedroom wall. That means it was kept there nearby author's bedroom. Somewhere a little place was there and they reserved or they kept it, the animal there, where he was tied securely, or so we thought, to a big fasten into the wall, a hook. They put a hook in the wall and they tied the monkey. A few hours later, when grandfather and I came back to release Toto, we found that the walls, which had been covered with some ornamental paper chosen by grandfather, now stood out as naked brick and plaster. See, very nicely it is said. When grandfather and this writer, both of them had a visit of monkey, they wanted to know, they wanted to collect some information about monkey. So they visited it. They found that everything was hodgepodge in a small room. Even you can see the blazer which was hanging on the wall. It was also somehow not in a good condition. It was torn by monkey, and he performed very dangerous or adventurous task or duty. We can say the peg in the wall had been raised from its socket. Peg was there, blazer was there, everything was lying on the floor, and it is done by this mischief monkey. And my school blazer, which had been hanging there, was in shreds. Shreds means torn in many pieces. I wonder what grandmother would say. Now grandmother, they are worrying about grandmother. If grandmother would come to know about the reality, then what would she tell? Everything was happening there, and they were just enjoying it. In spite of getting angry with the monkey, grandfather said, didn't worry. He did not worry even. He seemed pleased with Toto's performance. That means this grandfather was happy. In spite of disappointment, he was happy by the performance of monkey. And he said, today I observed, or I came to know, that this monkey has done some adventurous work. He was happy. Here it is a ornamental decorative, that means it is a decorative, naked, uncovered, raised means broke, socket, attachment, and shreds means cut into thin slices. Cut into thin slices which cannot mended, which cannot repair now. So it was difficult, and in such condition they have to buy another blazer and bag. Next point says, the writer and his grandfather went to Toto after a few hours. They went after a few hours. The sight was shocking. The Toto had torn the decorative wallpaper, and he had broken the hook and had escaped from his binding. Also, he tore writer's blazer into thin pieces that I told you here itself. Dear students, we can observe many few animals you can see here. The, of course, tortoise is there. Then a squirrel is there. Then also you can see the goat, the rabbit. These are the animals. They were in the zoo and they were living a happy time. Grandfather was quite delighted to see Toto's adventure. He felt that Toto was very clever, because he performed a clever duty or clever task, or he did something which was of course harmful for the family as well as to grandfather and writer. But then he considered Toto has done some adventure work, and it was so clever. He said that if they would have given him more time, he would have tied the thin pieces of the writer's torn blazer into a rope and would have escaped out of the window. Nicely said, if we would have given him some more time, then he would have done some another work. What? He would have tied, or he would have joined piece by piece of clothes and escaped from the window. That is what grandfather said. His presence in the home still a secret. Still his presence is secret. Toto was now transferred to a big cage in a servant's quarters, where a number of grandfathers a pet lived very socially together. Now this Toto was transferred to a place where many animals were kept, and it was decided by Toto and his grandson, that means writer. Then say here, grandfather's pets lived very sociably together. They did not fight. They did not do any harmful work to anyone. So they were living happily and sociably together. But the monkey wouldn't allow any of his companions to sleep at night, because we understand monkey animal is very mischief. It did not allow any of his companions to sleep peacefully. So many work had been done by this mischievous animal to his friends. Grandfather, who had to leave Dehradun the next day, he had to leave to Dehradun because he was a pensioner. He wanted to collect his pensions. So next day he supposed to leave. To Dehradun. Decided to take him alone because we understand this animal would not allow his companions to sleep well or to live a peacefully life. Therefore, he decided to take this mischievous animal along with him. Dear students, unfortunately, I could not accompany grandfather on the trip. On that trip, the writer did not go. Writer was left behind at home. But he told him, he told me about it afterwards. Means later on, the author, he was informed what had happened when he left home to Dehradun, sorry, Saharanpur. A big black canvas kit bag was provided for Toto. He arranged a big canvas kit bag for Toto. This, with some stores at the bottom, means in the bottom of the canvas kit bag, he also put some straw, because his new abode, it was his new abode, whose monkeys, it was arranged for monkey. When the bag was closed, there was no escape. He said, of course, when the bag was closed, there was no chance to escape for monkey. It was completely closed or chained. Toto could not get his hands through the opening, and the canvas was too strong for him to bite his way through. We understand the canvas, it was a very thick bag. It was made of a very thick piece of cloth, and therefore monkey cannot bite it easily and cannot come out. So grandfather, he thought to carry him in that type of bag. His efforts to get out only had the effect of making the bag roll about on the floor, occasionally jump into the air. See what is happening now. It becomes very interesting, because when grandfather was taking the bag along with him, and he kept on the floor of in the compartment, and what happened? The monkey was not able to come out, so he instead of that, he started rolling on the floor, and people who were traveling in the same compartment, they became attractive, or they attracted towards this bag. What is happening? What is in the bag? They were so curious to know what is happening. So it becomes a little bit difficult for grandfather to elaborate or to explain. But anyhow, the situation was there, such a situation was taken care of by grandfather. An exhibition that attracted a curious crowd of onlookers on the Dehradun railway platform. Dear student, abode means home, of course, the new word we get here. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur. They reached Saharanpur. Till that time, it remained in the bag itself. But while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway turnstile means a particular place where we are being checked by an officers. So that place is known as turnstile. Or turnstile it would be. Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag. At that point of time, it was so serious, or it was very difficult for the Toto to remain in the bag, and he he did something. He poked his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. That means ticket collector, he was present over there, and he gave a look. He poked his head and he wanted to come out. So the ticket collector, he was very clever, and he noticed all this activity happening on that spot. So ticket collector, he is demanding something. Let us see in the next slide. It says, he, poor man, was taken aback. Now this grandfather, he was taken aback. It means that he was surprised, and he was he was not in position to answer the ticket collector. But with great presence of mind and much to grandfather's annoyance, he said, "Sir," of course it was it is said for the ticket collector. Ticket collector was somehow not able to ask charges for the monkeys traveling. But then he dared to ask, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You will have to pay for it accordingly." It means, dear students, ticket collector demanded some money because he considered the monkey as a dog. He was pretending, or he was wanted to collect money from grandfather. But then he did not take the right or correct name, and in spite of that, he said, "Sir, you have to pay, and this is a dog," he said. But grandfather was able to convince him, "No, it is not." But then he could not understand, he could not listen the grandfather, and he had to pay three rupees. In vain did grandfather take Toto out of the bag. In vain did he try to prove that a monkey did not qualify as a dog, or as a quadruped. Toto was classified as a dog by the ticket collector, and 3 rupees was the sum handed over as his fare. And everything grandfather was trying to make him understand, it went in vain. It's an unsuccessful attempt. Quadruped means an animal which has 4 feet. That means 4 feet. And this monkey was having, of course, 2 feet, but then he used 2 feet for a different purpose. Fair ticket price. The next says, a great treat for Toto during cold winter evening was a large bowl of warm water. See, one more event took place here. What happened? Once upon a time, a monkey was provided hot water to take bath by grandmother. He would cunningly taste the temperature with his hand, and this monkey was so clever, he used to cunningly check or taste the temperature of the water, whether it is too hot or cold. So he wanted to check it, or he wanted to check the water. Then gradually step into the bath. First 1 foot, he would put first foot first, and then the other, as he had seen me doing, until he was into the water up to his neck. Means until he dipped till his neck, he will not come out. Once comfortably, he would take the soap in his hands off it and rub himself all over body. He will do whatever we do in the bathroom. When the water became cold, he would get out and run as quickly as he could to the kitchen fire in order to dry himself, because we understand it was so mischief, and in the time of cold season, it does certain things, and it becomes very interesting for others. If anyone laughed at him during this performance, Toto's feelings would be hurt, and he would refuse to go on with his bath. Yes, next thing. One day, Toto nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive. Yes, it happened. So one day he was about to boil himself, but then anyhow he was escaped from that hot water. Yes, One day at lunch time, see, very good incident happened here also. The first incident and second incident, this is the third. And before that, you know what happened? When grandfather was not able to convince, but then later on, grandmother, she was convinced with this mischief monkey. And you know what happened? Monkey was kept in the place where donkey was kept. So, because it was accepted by grandmother, and now both are living in a particular place, monkey and then also donkey. Once grandfather and Uther, both of them decided to visit it. Both of them decided to visit what is happening, because the name of the donkey was Nana. So they decided to visit, and they saw monkey was very much torturing or very much disturbing Nana the donkey. How he was pulling his ears and doing so many activities, so many things which was not good for a donkey, and they decided to keep it somewhere else. But after that, what happened, you know, they were treating the monkey as well they have to do. One day at lunchtime, something happened. Let us see. A large dish of pulao stood in the center of the dining table. Yes, food was prepared, pulao. The plate of the pulao was kept in the center of the dining table. We entered the room to find Toto stuffing himself with rice. The members of the family entered the dining room, and then before entering them, monkey, he was already there in the dining room, and he was, you know, stuffing. Stuffing means he was eating himself with rice. My grandmother screamed. Grandmother screamed, and Toto threw a plate at her. That means, dear students, it did something mischievous work. That means, threw a plate at a grandmother, and she felt very disappointed and very unhappy, and she wanted to do something. One of my aunts rushed forward, and at the same time, one of his grandfather, Arthur's aunt, rushed towards the monkey, and he did something else for her also. Received a glass of water in the face, and he threw a glass of water on her face also. When grandfather arrived, Toto picked up the dish of pulao. When grandfather entered the dining room, he did something. What did he do? He threw the plate. He threw the plate or dish of pulao and made his exit, and he ran away from there through a window. Through a window. We found him in the branch of the jackfruit tree. That means, you know, understand here, along with the dish of pulao, he ran through window and he sat on the branches of jackfruit tree. The dish still in his arms, dish was still in his arms. He remained there all afternoon, eating slowly through the rice, determined on finishing every grain. He determined and decided to finish every grain. And then in order to spite grandmother, who had screamed at him, and he threw the dish down from the tree. Grandmother, she screamed, and listening her very sharp scream, it threw the dish of the pulao down from the tree and chattered. Yes, monkey, if they cry or they make some type of voice, we say chattered. With a delight, when it broke into 100 pieces, the dish or the vessel of the dish was broken in 100 pieces, and it became so happy and so delighted. Spite means a desire to hurt. or anyone, sorry, annoy or offend someone. Chatter means the sound made by monkey. Large kitchen, kettle had, yeah, one more incident happened with this monkey. What happened, you know? Large kitchen kettle had been left on the fire to boil for tea. For tea and Toto, a large kitchen vessel or kettle, it was there, kept on the, might call store, to boil water or tea. Finding himself with nothing better to do, this monkey, he found out that he was not feeling better. Anywhere he went to kitchen, he went to different room, he was not feeling better because it was too cold. So he decided to remove the lid. Yes, lid means the lid was kept on the dish vessel or kettle, and he decided to remove it, finding the water just warm enough for a bath. And he thought that, okay, this water is good to take bath. He got in and he went into the kettle with his head sticking out from the open kettle, and he opened and put himself inside the kettle. This was just fine for a while. Of course, he felt fine for a while. Little bit time, he felt okay until the water began to boil. Toto then raised himself a little. He felt okay. It is cold. It is good water. And he comes out and he gets into it. He sits there. But finding it cold outside, he gets in. Of course, I said, sat down again, and he continued hopping up and down for some time until grandmother arrived and howled him. Half boiled out of the kettle, howled him means pulled him out. Yes, we are going to finish the lesson, dear students. The last paragraph, last slide, it says, obviously Toto was not the sort of pet we could hear. Grandfather realized. Ultimately, he realized that Toto was not a pet animal, and we cannot keep this type of animal in our house. We could keep for a long, he said, we cannot keep it for a long. Even grandfather realized that. We were not well-to-do and could not afford the frequent loss of dishes because they cannot afford the frequent loss because one day or two day, every day he was creating some problem or the other, and this loss of house we cannot fulfill or we cannot afford, like dishes, clothes and curtains and wallpaper. So grandfather found the Tonga driver and sold Toto back to him. Grandfather, now what did he do? He found out the Tonga driver and he sold it back to the same person, but then he did not get the money as he bought. He got less money for only 3 rupees. Finally, grandfather realized that Toto was not suitable to be kept at home. Yes, ultimately or finally he realized this animal, this place is not suitable for this type of animal. So he decided to sell it, and he did so. They could not afford the frequent losses that he gave them. He tore clothes, curtains and wallpapers and broke dishes. So many things he did, and it was harmful for the family, the family members. So the grandfather sold Toto back to the same Tonga driver for some of 3 rupees. Dear students, we have completed the lesson. Here, I just would like to ask you questions that if you keep the pet animals, how are you going to treat them, or what are you going to do with them? You need to take care of them properly, and if they are not coming from the background, you should not keep them. Just try to understand or just try to differentiate the wild as well as pet animal, so that we can treat them well. Thank you very much.